Let's learn about the blood. The blood is a connective tissue which consists of substances suspended in a fluid matrix called plasma. These substances include red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. Let's take a closer look at red blood cells, or erythrocytes. Red blood cells carry oxygen. They have a unique shape called a biconcave disc that increases the surface area. Red blood cells contain hemoglobin molecules that carry oxygen. Oxygen attaches to hemoglobin to form oxyhemoglobin. This happens in the lungs. Hemoglobin releases oxygen in the tissues to form deoxyhemoglobin. Red blood cells live for about 120 days. They are then recycled in the liver and spleen. There, hemoglobin is broken down into heme and globin components. Heme is further broken down into iron and biliverdin, a pigment. The globin portions are recycled as plasma proteins. The biliverdin is converted to bilirubin and excreted in the bile. Red blood cells form in the bone marrow. The kidneys and liver detect low oxygen levels and secrete a hormone called erythropoietin, which travels through the blood to the bone marrow. Erythropoietin promotes differentiation of a stem cell called the hemocytoblast into a mature red blood cell, or erythrocyte. Let's look at white blood cells, or leukocytes, next. White blood cells can fall into two classifications. Those with a granular cytoplasm are called granulocytes. These include neutrophils, basophils, and eosinophils. Those without a granular cytoplasm are called agranulocytes and include the monocytes and lymphocytes. The neutrophil has a granular cytoplasm and segmented nucleus. Its function is the phagocytosis of debris and pathogens. The basophil contains large granules in the cytoplasm. These granules contain substances that promote inflammation, which include histamine, heparin, prostaglandins, and leukotrienes. Eosinophils have a bilobe nucleus. Eosinophils are elevated in allergic reactions and parasitic infections. They also perform phagocytosis of pathogens. The monocyte is the largest white blood cell and has a kidney-shaped nucleus. It performs phagocytosis of debris and pathogens. Monocytes are called macrophages when they exist in tissue. Lymphocytes are the smallest white blood cells and have a large nucleus. There are several types of lymphocytes, but they all function in fighting off pathogens in our immune systems. Platelets are tiny cell fragments. Platelets function in hemostasis, which is the controlling of bleeding. Platelets form plugs to help stop bleeding. Plasma is mostly water and contains a lot of substances. These include cells, plasma proteins, carbohydrates, fats, and proteins, electrolytes, and dissolved gases such as carbon dioxide and oxygen. We hope you've learned something about the blood, and see you next time.